Okay.
All right. So we know who you're voting for.
Okay. So you're gonna be there.
Wednesday night. Yeah, it's 7 o'clock at the Fraunthal. This is the fourth year for the Mega 2000 Awards, and it honors people in Muskegon County in various categories. And somehow I get up there and make a fool out of myself.
But people love it.
Introduce presenters, and they get these mega awards.
Okay.
Well, why do you want to do this?
I don't know. I mean, for years I would write a lot of television, and never would I ever get in front of anybody to do anything. And somehow here, I've changed my mode of operation and find myself in front of people. But
you're
I don't
bribed,
know for how
you?
Long.
I had to be like almost 4 years ago, first time I met you. And I'm sure you don't remember, but
I do remember, and
he's trying to erase it from his memory.
Both of us shouldn't have been at that place.
Yeah, okay. All right, you remember. Okay, all right, that's good.
What place were you at?
I don't know.
You don't know? Really, you don't know?
No.
Oh, okay, so.
But now it's interesting.
Yeah, okay. All right, well, what it was I used to run one of the TV stations over here, TV 40, and I was in the back there. You were the first guest, I think, on the first show of Annette and Ron Morris, A.M. Muskegon. You remember that?
I remember that. I remember the station.
You've been having nightmares since then, right?
I kind of had to sit between a flower and a little thing that said bingo.
Right. That's the place. You remember now.
Yeah. And they had one camera.
Yeah, at that time, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And,
it was fun. It was fun back then. I remember that, yeah. Okay, and so I gave you like the first guest, and when I saw you on there, it was an excellent show. You did a wonderful job. It was a lot of fun.
Thank you.
It was a lot of fun. And you were mentioning too about some of the TV shows that you've written in the past.
What are they?
I started out in variety television, writing Tony Orlando and Dawn, and then Mac Davis, and then went on to Welcome Back Cotter. And
you wrote for Welcome Back Cotter?
Yeah.
How funny.
Yeah.
Close for Comfort and Silver Spoons. A lot of different shows.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So he's...
But you decided to stay here in Muskegon.
Well, when we moved the theater from Traverse City here and went from a small 700-seat theater in the round to this...
Beautiful.
Large Fraunthal, you know, that we felt that we had to spend more time and try and take the time to build success and... hopefully we're on our way. It's been a little rocky, but things get better and better.
Well, I think right now is a good time because I think things are really turning around. Nothing but positive from now on.
Yeah, and I mean, I think just a lot is happening to Muskegon that makes it, a place where people are all of a sudden thinking about coming and spending a weekend or... they're discovering the beaches here everything else.
Not only that, but now people have jobs, so they can actually come and spend some money to come see you guys over there.
Right.
Yeah.
There you go.
So that always helps things out.
Well, we're working.
That's right. At Saturday morning.
We're actually getting paid, too. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Those fangible things.
Well, you called me during my break, luckily.
Oh, okay, good. You were doing what?
My day job.
Your day job.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I like to think of myself as a motivational speaker, but technically the official title is a disgruntled postal employee.
Oh. So, what is your claim to fame?
You stumped me on that one.
Yeah.
Oh gosh, I don't know.
We can talk about climax.
I was
again,
on
if you like.
Even the improv.
Oh, well, really? That's kind of neat.
Not really. Yeah, I got the Hug Bud.
Hug Bud?
Yep, Bud Friedman.
All right.
You have to hug Bud when they get off stage.
Oh, that's right, yeah, I forgot about that.
No, that's not a euphemism. I actually got the Hug Bud.
And did you enjoy it?
Well, certainly.
Okay,
Who wouldn't? Just check it.
I hear that you also appear over...
I'm sorry?
You also appear over at Chaplin's, too. That's kind of a cool place.
Yeah, I work over at Chaplin's. I work all over the country, actually. I've been in, like, 47 states and 3 countries. And
of course, Georgia.
And of course.
What
are you known for in your routine?
Condoms.
Okay, there you go.
I like to hand out lots and lots of condoms.
Do you?
So bring the kids.
You're a responsible guy.
The family
oriented.
That's
what I'm there for.
A postman who hands out condom. That's a responsible.
That's right. Don't forget disgruntled.
Oh my goodness.
It's too early for this. It's really too early for this.
It is quite early.
Yeah. Anyway.
This is like the middle of the night for me.
Okay. Well, that's true. It will be for you.
What did you say you had to do?
Reload.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that was just
you're reloading.
Took us a while to get that
low.
One, but.
Yeah, it's my break. I have to reload during the break.
Do you have any famous routines that you do? Do you like you just want to like rattle off something?
Well, there's one of Steve Martin that he used to do that I'd like to repeat for you.
Okay.
You wanted a famous routine, not one of mine.
Oh.
Sorry. What are your famous routines?
Honey, do I have any famous routines?
Ones that make Georgia people laugh.
Oh man, usually just shiny objects.
Shiny objects.
You know, I was in Atlanta, and about a month ago, I was in Atlanta, and this woman came up to me after the show, and she was with a couple other people, and she said, you know, we enjoyed you. And I said, well, you know, we're all in Georgia. So I thought that was kind of odd.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. There you go.
You can hear more things like that at the Muskegon Club in Manhattan tonight.
There you go. Now they're happy.
I'm sure it's going to be packed now.
That's not one of my jokes. That's the opening act joke.
I see. Okay. Well, yeah, okay. This is good. Who is the opening act, too, by the way?
Jimmy Murtaugh.
I haven't actually worked with him yet. It might be a her, for all I know.
But he's really good, isn't he?
Evidently.
Yeah.
He wouldn't be there in Muskegon, would he?
That's right.
Of course.
I mean, you know, it's that kind of a thing. You go to New York, you go to Chicago, you come to Muskegon.
That's right.
That's right.
And you open for Mark Boyd.
There you go.
Who? Who? Yeah.
Who's he?
You didn't ask me about my baby.
Oh.
Yeah? What about your baby? That's his day job.
No, we just had a baby 4 months ago, my wife.
Oh,
and I. Yeah,
brand
I'm
new.
Pretty proud. Just all as proud good. As a man can be without actually being the father. I am.
Oh,
there
this
you
is
go.
Good.
Mm.
Okay.
Well, she done with the father.
That
with
explains
some,
why you're disgruntled.
She done with the father with some guy that she used to date way before we got married, which means she's been pregnant for 8.5 years.
Yeah, this is good.
There you go.
Isn't that odd?
Condoms will do that. Yeah, okay.
I was busy on the road handing them out, I guess.
It could have been the sperm bank.
Unfortunately, you didn't hand them to the right guy.
Because evidently,
he didn't
come to my show.
Well, what's your baby's name?
Jessica.
Aw.
He had to say it just like that.
Well, how about if you put her on the phone?
did you name her after Jessica Lange? Is she going to win an Oscar?
Yeah, that's right.
Is she going to win an Oscar? I'm too old, so maybe you ask one of those other ones.
Good morning. Good morning.
And we're talking with Oscar Socia.
That's right.
I like that. Right, Raul? Well, I don't even talk about what we're going to talk about yet because I want to talk about our names.
Mm-hmm.
It's to me, it's a tribute just to talk to another Oscar.
You don't get too many to do that, do you?
That's right. There's not many of us.
Right.
And we talked a little earlier, and you were saying your dad's name is Oscar. My dad's name is Oscar. We should have an Oscar festival, I think.
How about that?
I think so.
It would be unique.
Well, they got a Bob Day, you know. So
yeah.
We should have an Oscar Day.
That's right.
We'll form it. We'll start it. An Oscar Day.
Okay.
Anyway, the reason I'm calling you have the Bayrama Fish Fly
Festival. Correct.
And that's in New Baltimore. That's like right at my old stomping grounds.
Yeah, it's right downtown New Baltimore.
Yeah. Okay. I used to live in Mount Clemens for years, and
born and raised in Mount Clemens.
Oh, were you?
Yeah.
See. And we never knew each other.
How about that?
Okay. This is weird.
Yeah, I graduated from St. Mary's High.
Oh, that's why. So you went to St. Mary's, I went
you
to
Mount
Clemens.
Clemens
High.
Oh, know. Okay.
Of course, were you in the Glee Club or or at all over at the
St. Mary's? Oh, no, I can't hold a tune in the
booker
basket. Well,
there you go. There you go. I went to St. Mary's, but I never, you know. It's amazing, you know, what you find out.
Yeah, true.
Anyway, speaking about the Bayrama Fish Fly Festival, that's a mouthful.
That's a mouthful.
Now, I remember growing up, every time we go out for an ice cream or something, right around this time of year, you'd go out there and you would go to the ice cream parlor or wherever, and the walls were covered with fish flies.
Well, you know, Oscar, we came to that name in 1974, and that year was the worst year of fish flies. Of course, you knew at that time we held our festival a week after the 4th of July.
Oh, okay.
And now we moved it up, and we moved it up again. Because last year we had extremely warm weather, and the fish flies were out early.
Yeah.
So we moved it up again, so hopefully we're going to miss them.
Oh, okay, so there won't be any fish flies to honor this year?
Well, we'll have a few. They'll make their appearance, but they're not like not like they used to.
Now, do you, just out of curiosity, before we talk about the festival, do you have any idea what fish flies are good for?
You know, what the ecology does for the ecology, I don't know. The fish feed on them when they come out.
Oh, okay, so they're food then.
Basically. Other than that, I guess they're the food for the fish.
Because they only last for like a week, don't they?
Yeah, well, they're heavy for a week, but they last about 3 weeks, and they decline, you know.
Oh, okay.
But at that time, you know, fishing isn't any good because they do feed on the fish flies.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. So the fish fly get their delicacy once a year with
I guess
flies.
So.
Okay, so tell me what the Fish Fly Festival is all about.
Well, yeah, of course, you know, this is my 29th year.
Okay.
And the Fish Fly Festival has been in existence. It was called Bayorama, Bayorama. Now it's the Bayorama
Fish
Fly Festival.
I remember that now.
Right.
Bayorama, yeah, okay.
Yeah, and it's been in existence since 1965. And I started to work on the festival in 1968, and I'm here. I guess I'm married to it, you might say. Huh?
Okay.
But, you know, right now, especially this year, and I think in the future, we're trying to make it more and more a family festival.
Okay.
And in fact, I hear the games out there for the kids now. They've got tractor pull and big wheel race and so forth going on right now.
Okay.
And each day they have, you know, different programs for the kids, teenagers on down. And this is what we'd like to see. The families come out here. And, of course, we have held it in downtown New Baltimore all these years. But I don't know if you recently know, we recently purchased 40 acres from the Archdiocese of Detroit. It's still in the city, and this is going to be a city park, soccer fields, baseball fields, tennis courts. And probably in 2 years, we'll make our debut out there.
Oh,
and
really?
The festival will be held on this 40 acres, and that's where it'll be permanently held.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
oh,
we're,
but New Baltimore is such a cool place, though.
The thing is, our problem here is parking.
Oh, okay.
We have limited parking, and out there we'll have ample parking.
Now, aren't you, like, based right on the main drag there, too?
Pardon me?
Isn't it, like, based right on the main drag
there?
Oh,
yes.
Yeah, okay.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot more industry over there now than there used to be when I was there 10 years ago.
Yeah,
yeah. So there's a lot of so is that bad, though, or I think it'd be a good thing, though, wouldn't it? You would bring it there and for the other businesses to...
You mean our festival out there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It has its good and bad points. And hopefully that, you know, once we're settled there, it'll work out well for us. I says basically, we're going out there because of parking.
Okay.
And we're very limited here, but we draw a big crowd.
Okay, yeah, because I remember the Bayorama. I remember that now. Mm-hmm. Now, you have, like, everything out there, like the rides for kids and the whole bit,
Oh,
right?
They have the rides for kids. They have a huge festival tent. And they, like today, the Chamber of Commerce met in the festival tent today, and that was nice. Saturday is going to be especially nice for kids. They have all kind of programs in the festival tent for the kids.
Okay.
And it's really nice.
Okay, so that's going on now till when?
Through Sunday. Uh-huh.
Okay, so if they want to take a trip now, they can go to see
Yeah. And, you know, it's nice that they can, if they bring their children in, and, you know, all day rides from noon until 10, you know, they can get a wristband, and that's $12, which is really nice for a family. You know,
They'll
know what they can spend.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so did, just out of curiosity, did you change the name for more of a catchier name, just to, so people would say, what
we,
fish
we
fly?
Changed our name in 1975 because it was 74. Actually, we had so many fish flies, we had to close down the rides because the rides were just slip,
filled,
you know, on the cog wheels.
Yeah.
They wouldn't spin. They would just spin and not move. So they had to close down at 9 o'clock. And we thought, oh, my gosh. And we had TV 2, 4, and 7 out here, you know. We took advantage of that and changed the name to Fish Fly. So it's very catchy. And people will say, oh, you're from New Baltimore. That's where they got that funny festival, you know.
Exactly. Well, yeah, that's the whole thing because the fish flies are just nuts.
That's right.
So, I mean, I've never, ever been in when we were growing up there, though, it was normal. You were used to it. You knew it was going to happen.
Yeah, the more the fish flies, the cleaner the water.
Yeah.
You know, Lake
true.
Erie, the fish flies are just coming back.
Lake
Erie is cleaning up. And,
yeah, because when I was talking to people around here in Muskegon about fish flies, they didn't even know what they were. much about them. So.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Oscar.
Okay, Oscar, it's nice talking to you.
I'm talking with George here. George Wilson, is it?
It is George Wilson, and I'm the impresario of Sight and Sound.
Okay, and
of the Scabble Comet.
Okay, I thought you were like the Grand Poobah of clowns.
Well, we don't mess around. This is a Scottsville Philharmonic that I think for the however they've been running parades in Muskegon. You're in Muskegon, right?
Muskegon, right.
All right, Oscar. Well, all they've been running, I think we start with the Seaway, and then whatever title you'd call that big parade in June,
okay.
We've been there.
Okay.
And right now, I understand we've received a lot of pressure. Oscar Osmo.
Right.
That's you.
Right.
I got this from a usually reliable source down in Muskegon.
Okay.
The Sheriff's Department. Sheriff Carter told me this.
Okay.
It's he knows Oscar well.
Okay.
You're a regular customer?
Not recently.
But he says that you have an enormous amount of talent. We heard about you last year when we played a show for him. So I'm here we're actually going to invite you to march with the Scalpel Clown Band this coming Saturday in Muskegon.
Oh, so I don't have to go through an interview or anything? I'm just invited?
Huh?
I'm invited.
You're invited.
Okay, now what did he say my talent was?
Well, your talent was making a lot of noise.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I do that.
And he said you've been known to make a lot of noise and make a fool of yourself.
Yeah, I do that, right.
And that's probably the best qualifications you can to join our organization.
I'm very good at that. Yeah.
Now, I understand you play the Fenorton.
Okay.
I mean, there's not too many Fenorton players, you know, around.
Right,
and
right.
This is why we're really especially interested with you, because we had one, but he died and went to heaven.
Okay.
Looking one ever since, and we found out you are a Fenorton player.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I've been.
Where did you learn the Fenorton, sir?
Where did I learn that? Well, yeah. I tell you what, my father from Norway, he brought the Fenorton over and he taught me.
Yeah, so. Well, I thought it was Juilliard. Somebody said you did go to Juilliard.
Well, that was my cousin.
Juilliard. Yeah. Well, the Fenortons are in the family. But anyway, yeah. A Fenorton, of course, is a unique instrument that any place in the band that you walk with, whatever section, you blend right in.
Okay.
Including the drums.
All right. They've been telling me around here too that I don't need to dress up as a clown because I pretty much come.
Well, yeah, I've understood that when it comes to high fashion coutier, you ain't.
That's right.
Is that true?
That's true.
Well, yeah. you've got to remember we do insist on clean shorts and socks.
Yeah, that I can do.
Yeah, you can do.
Okay, I can handle that part.
Now, sir, we don't want you to be nervous because there's going to be thousands and thousands and thousands of people in Muskegon this coming Saturday.
Okay.
Yeah, that's one of the great all-time parades.
Right.
There is. Have you ever been in the great all-time parade in Muskegon?
I've ridden in the trunk once.
You were in the trunk? Yeah. Right. I mean, you can't get out there and stroll among the masses.
Yeah, see,
man.
That's what I was wondering. That's a long parade. That goes on for quite a while.
Yes, it does. It's a great parade. I'll tell you, last year, and it was fantastic. Probably one of the greatest parades I've ever had. And they've had some great parades in Muskegon for many, many years, whether it was the Seaway or the Lumbertown or the Music Festival, whatever they call it.
Right.
They've had some great parades, but the last couple of years, I'll tell you, it's been the best ever.
Okay, Summer Celebration is what they call it now.
Summer Celebration.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, Muskegon is a great town.
It is.
And so we're going to send you a Clown Band Code of Honor and Ethics.
Okay.
And you have to sign your name with in blood.
In blood.
But, you know, hey, we're just sort of like, you know, the boys, the what do they call them, the happy fellows, or the... Anyway... But, I mean, because, you know, we don't just turn anybody loose on the streets
right.
of Muskegon.
I understand that. Okay. Yes.
And meet us at the Muskegon Eagles.
All right.
And, again, like I said, clean shorts and socks.
Right.
And so you're Fenorton.
My Fenorton.
You're Fenorton. And do you play that in treble clef or bass clef?
I never got that far with Julia.
Well, you've got crushed Fenorton, and regardless how you do it, it's there.
Right.
And we're looking forward to seeing you. Now, how will I recognize you? And, I mean, you know, there's a lot of people in Muskegon. Just every once in a while you see one of the strange ones. Now, I understand from many of your great friends in the Sheriff's Department, you're strange.
Yeah.
So how will I notice you right off the bat, sir?
I have very, very large, I have very, very large feet.
Large feet?
Yeah.
You got some anchors.
I got some anchors, yeah.
You got some anchors.
I got some ski
boots. Okay, well then, let's see. We'll meet you probably down at the Muskegon Eagles. That's on Western Avenue by the Heritage Park.
Okay.
Oh, and also, sir, we've also booked you. We're doing a show there afterward.
Okay.
When you get done in the parade, you're going to have you do 20 minutes of the soft shoe dancing and death-free parquet patter.
Okay.
You can do that.
And I can do it with the, I got to do it with the Fenorton?
And then the Fenorton, yes.
Okay. Out of curiosity, since it's such a long way, and I'm not used to walking that far, can I possibly rent a wheelbarrow or
a wheelbarrow?
Yeah, is that a possibility?
Oh, hey, sir, this is guts parading. You get right out there, and you come right down Western Avenue.
Got to give my blood. I got to walk for miles.
Yeah, well, it's good for your soul. Good, and then of course at the other end you get the Heritage Park. There's some good friends in Muskegon that have this rest and relaxation tent.
Okay.
We get you out of the hot sun.
Uh huh.
And get some cooling liquids into you.
Oh, okay.
That'll do it, and then we'll buy you.
In the beverage tent.
Yeah, well, we did the entertainment tent.
Oh, okay. All right.
And so we're really looking forward to this, Oscar. And remember, nobody in the Scalpel Clown Band ever finishes last.
One more time on that one?
Nobody in the Scalpel Clown Band ever finishes last.
Oh, okay.
So you've got to hold your own and with the Fort Norton and then in the beverage tent.
Okay.
You can do that.
In the beverage tent, I think I'll be okay, but then with the Fort Norton, I'm not sure.
Remember, Sheriff Carter will be watching you.
Okay. I know Sheriff Carter.
All right, sir.
All right, thank you very much,
Jim. Well, and have yourself a good day the rest of the way, and tell the good people of Muskegon that the Scalpel Clown Band, starring the one and only, I heard somebody say thank God in the background there, Oscar Oswald, right?
I guess. I'll be there.
All right, we'll see you, Oscar.
For and all. Thank you,
Jim. Have a good time until then.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye now.
Okay.
Why do you want to do this?
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, for years, I would write a lot of television, and never would I ever get in front of anybody to do anything. And somehow here, I've changed my mode of operation and find myself in front of people. But
you
know, I don't know for how long.
I met you.
I had to be like almost 4 years ago. Bad about
God, I remember that. I remember the station.
You've been having nightmares since then, right?
I kind of had to sit between a flower and a little thing that said bingo.
Right, that's the place. You remember now.
Yeah, and they had one camera.
Yeah, at that time, yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
And
it was fun. It was fun back then. I remember that. Yeah. Okay, and so I gave you like the first guest, and when I saw you on there, it was an excellent show. You did a wonderful job. It was a lot of fun.
Thank you.
It was a lot of fun. And you were mentioning too about some of the TV shows. Okay.
All right. So we know who you're voting for.
Okay, so you're gonna be there. Wednesday night,
yeah, at 7 o'clock at the Fraunthal. This is the fourth year for the Mega 2000 Awards, and it honors people in Muskegon County in various categories. And somehow I get up there and make a fool out of myself.
But people love it.
Introduce presenters, and they get these mega awards.
Shows that you've written in the past.
What are they?
Oh, I started out in variety television, writing Tony Orlando and Dawn, and then Mac Davis, and then went on to Welcome Back, Cotter. And
you wrote for Welcome Back, Cotter?
Yeah.
How funny.
Yeah.
Close for Comfort and Silver Spoons, a lot of different shows.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So he's...
But you decided to stay here in Muskegon.
Well, when we moved the theater from Traverse City here and went from a small...
First time I met you. And I'm sure you don't remember, but...
I do remember, and
he's trying to erase it from his memory.
Both of us shouldn't have been at that place.
Yeah, okay. All right, you remember. Okay, all right, that's good.
What place were you at?
I don't know.
You don't know? Really, you don't know?
No.
Oh, okay, so...
But now it's interesting.
Yeah, okay. All right, well, what it was I used to run one of the TV station over here, TV 40, and I was in the back there. You were the first guest, I think, on the first show of Annette and Ron Morris, A.M. Muskegon. You remember that?